Hi, my name is Victor Bart. Welcome to Retro Machines. And let's continue working on the Alpha PC 164 LX motherboard. And last time we couldn't get it up and running. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. If you want your circuit board design realized and printed, you should check out PCBWay. Starting prices as low as $5 for a one or two layer design with worldwide shipping. Place your order now, links in the description. But what I found out about this motherboard, that you need to install two memory modules that are the same with ECC. And I didn't have them when I was testing, but Dave Pennings sent me some ECC modules, PC100, so we're gonna try them out. He also sent some more memory, but this is not ECC. And Alan sent me a nice cool block, and this is for a Pentium Pro. So the AT Pentium Pro build will get an upgraded cooler someday, and then I will probably upgrade some more stuff about that machine, because it's a cool machine and it's a Pentium Pro. But let's get back to the Alpha machine, because an Alpha PC is even cooler than a Pentium Pro, and the Pentium Pro is the coolest x86 CPU. So let's get this board up and running, I hope. There's only one thing that happened last time with this board, and when I was turning it on for the first time here with screwdriver, I saw a light flash, and I didn't know what it was. But someone else even noticed in the footage, and I slowed it down and checked it, and maybe I can put it on the screen right now. And there was a spark flying from somewhere here, over to here, probably from the cache module to something here. And it was really a lightning bolt spark. So I hope this board didn't get damaged by it, otherwise we might just have a fried board. That would be really sad, because this is really cool hardware. Let's install the memory, and I think this is the first bank. So let's put it in, click clack. Now the video card, Matrox, let's try it in this slot. So let's see what happens. Nothing. Is this power switch broken? Okay, now I know why the power supply wasn't working. Okay, the power is on the board. The fan is spinning. The keyboard is flashing. And the monitor is on. Yes, Alpha PC 164 LX. Nice graphic. Testing memory. I love this BIOS. 533 MHz. We have 256 MB of memory. Testing memory. Haha! It's working! Press F2 to end setup and configure system. Display. System board information. 2 MB of cache. PCI. Matrox Millennium is detected. I think this board will get the Matrox Millennium as video card. ISA bridge, not sure. Oh, the IDE controller. No SCSI devices detected. ISA memory configuration. Awesome! We have a working system. So I hope the spark wasn't destructive. Install Windows NT utilities. About Alpha BIOS May 97. I think I'm gonna take some pictures to make some people happy that it is running. Not sure what's happening here, but it is doing strange things. Reset the machine. Machine check occurred. Firmware. Firmware monitor. It's flipping. Q2 quit. Let's turn it off for now. So the first thing that we need to do is install the CPU cooler like the proper way, because the clips aren't the way to mount it, because there are some threaded bolts here, and here there are two nuts inside. So we need to get rid of the fan for now and then bolt it to the CPU. Nice fan with a metal core, Panaflow DC brushless, Matsushita Electrics, made in Japan. And this fan is brand new. So let's remove this clip. I don't think we need it if we just use the threaded bolts. I think they are aluminium bolts. Let's get a tool for it, because I need to tighten that up here in the holes. And here you see a close-up of it. Nicely machined cool block, because the sidewalls where the screws go in is thicker. So super high quality, instead of having a screw between the fins and that it can bend out. In this little bag, there's the original heat pad, if it gets out. It's probably stuck in here for more than 25 years. So that will go here, and then the cool block on top, and then squeeze it down. But I think I will keep this original in the motherboard box, because we have now modern solutions for it. It doesn't want to get back in the little bag. Let's just use Noctua NT-H2 thermal paste. I think keeping the pad original is better. So if we now swap CPUs, we don't have to get rid of the pad. So let's put on the block, and the bolts are not metric, but some imperial stuff. So I found a socket 12 that fits a little bit. It has a bit of play, but it fits here in the hole. So let's just install it with that. The hex nut is a quarter 20 2011 T3 aluminium. Oh, the torque to 20 lbs. I don't have my torque tool here at home, so I maybe do that later. And here you see the thermal pad needs to be under it, but that is normal. And it is a craft foil thermal pad. Oh, 2.3 nanometer. So that is not much. Oh, and the nut is a 7/16 inch socket. And then put the fan back with the fan grill. I really love this logo. What I like to try out is two SCSI controllers. I think I had this in my Alpha PC 600, and this is an Ultra 2 White Tecram, a DC 390 U2W. And I have this diamond fire port with a SymBIOS logic chip. So yeah, it would be also nice if this would work, because it's really period correct. And this one, it says here on this chip 95, but ultra too wide in 95, not sure. So let's install it and see if it's detected by the BIOS. SCSI BIOS initialization. Nice. We have a SCSI option. And it gives now a black screen, but if I do caps lock, it's still working. So, not sure what's happening, but let's try out the other SCSI controller. Also SCSI BIOS, Diamond Multimedia. Okay, I think this works better. Yes, I think we're gonna use the diamond card in this system. And I think also that it has built-in drivers in Windows NT 4.0, because that is what I gonna run with this, because this is made for Windows NT. Display system information, PCI configuration, NCR SCSI controller. Huh? This is strange. The date is almost correct. It's now the 13th of October, and I changed the BIOS battery. This is really, really weird that it holds the date after so many years. Okay, that's cool. Maybe it has some kinds of capacitor that holds a little bit of charge for the time battery. Not sure what happens when I put install Windows NT. This option requires that you run a function CD-ROM player, power down the system, blah blah blah. Okay. The Alpha ATX board is working, which is really awesome. And we have a working SCSI card, video card and memory. But I still gonna pause this project and continue with it later, because in February the Brain Drain LAN party in Sweden will be there again. So I want to go there with a completely new build, and I need some time for it to build it. And I'm gonna show you in the end of the video which motherboard I'm gonna use. I think you will be really excited, because it's a brand new motherboard. So let's get rid of this and first test something else out with Alpha CPUs, because if you have seen the previous video of more than 1.5 hours of the Home Computer Museum, you saw that I bought two digital Multias with Alpha 166 CPUs. And of course I can make a video where I pull them apart, show them all the specs, show them everything. And so no, let's just try them out in this video, but without all the technical details and close looks. I will do that in another video where I really gonna play with it, but I just want to know, will they work? And I have two of them, and this one has a broken front. So this one is for spare and this one is to use, and I really hope both will work. But it's cool to have spares, because this is a non-standard form factor. It's basically a laptop in a mini desktop. But all that detail will be in a different video than this. And this one has normal VGA, normal PS2, very PC-like connection, so it's easy to test out. The keyboard is flashing, the LED is on. It makes noise. And the fan is probably worn out. And we have a green screen. And probably there's an operating system on it. Multia SRM console. Some test images. Nice, nice, nice. BL5 Toshiba SCSI bus, 32 megabytes of memory. So that's a good amount. Okay, this is really worn out. Switching network. And the Toshiba is probably the hard drive, and we have a SCSI bus that is detected. And the network card. Oh, and we are now in the console, so let's type help. Okay, this machine is just working, but needs a fan replacement. I think I will ask Noctua to provide some fans. See if they like the mini machines. So it's good to know what's wrong with the machines, then I can prepare. And I didn't have any battery errors. And I need to check it out further if they need new batteries, because I have a special 4.5 volt block. So I maybe can also prepare just fresh battery option. So this is the one with the broken front. It's broken here, it's cracked here. Here's even a piece missing, and I have the pieces for here. So I probably can make it good enough to keep it as a complete system. Okay, also keyboard flashing. This fan doesn't make that much noise. Also the monitor's on. Probably working systems. Multi-SMR console. Oh, warning, battery is dead. Good to know it, I need new batteries. But they still boot up without any special things. 32 megabytes of memory. Also on Toshiba hard drive, network card, SCSI. Working machine. So I need new fans, and upgrading the fans is really important in these little machines, because they like to overheat. Also, it's not recommended to put them flat and then a monitor on top, but you need to put them on the side and with a special stand, but I don't have the stand. So maybe if I just upgrade the cooling, I can have enough airflow that I just can use them as a little desktop. But it's cool, both are working. So let's shut this off and show you the motherboard that I'm gonna use for the LAN party build. I will go to the Brain Drain LAN party with Casper, the maker of the Voodoo 5 9000. And like last year, I want to have a better system than him. Last year I was completely successful in that with my Quantum 3D Alchemy system. So yeah, I need to have a system that is equally as cool, but not the Quantum 3D Alchemy, because 1000 km in the car is pretty risky for a system like that. So I want to build a system with short expansion cards, but awesome CPUs. So what do we have here? An Aopa server motherboard, the DX2G Plus. So what do we have here? A brand new motherboard. And here, a CPU terminator. And this is not slot 1, this is slot 2. Yes, we're gonna do a slot 2 build. And this one is special, because normally, oh, this is the brackets for the CPUs. Normally, with this motherboard, you can't only one box, like this. And this box is pretty cool, because this is the most epic CPU cooler for slot 2. With a Sunon fan, completely aluminium, brand new. And when I bought this motherboard, a friend of mine bought also a motherboard like this. So I bought his second cooler. So we had like one of the boards complete with the two original coolers. More boxes with brackets. The other cooler. And it's cushy cables. And here we have the board itself. It's a full size RTX board. So here we have a brand new AO board, dual slot 2, with its super cool nice coolers, 4 SD banks, a GX chipset, HDP, 6 PCI, 1 ISO slot, Adaptec Ultra 2 Wide SCSI on board, 2 IDEs, floppy SCSI ports, 50 pin SCSI, so it's probably a dual channel chip. It's just an amazing board. And I'm gonna build it up for the LAN party. And here we have even a network card on board, so that saves a PCI slot. So maybe this is an IRQ nightmare board, but I'm gonna use it with an AWA64 Colt in it. And for the video card, I need to have your opinion. I liked the Matrox G400 Max for this board, or a GeForce 1. And then, of course, both with Voodoo 2 SLI setups, because we have enough PCI slots. Or what video card would you use? And the Voodoo 5500 will not go in this build, because it's a too long card, and with the shakes of traveling, it's a too big risk. So I rather have a cheaper, simpler, shorter card for this build, because I don't want to damage really good hardware. So let me know what kind of video card you would use with dual Pentium 3 Xeon 700 makers with 2MB cache, and I'm running Windows 2000. So yeah, if you like to support me, you can support me monthly on Patreon and get access to my awesome Discord server, or use my Amazon affiliated links. Thanks for watching.